Hi, good morning class 5. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing well. Okay, great. So what I'm going to do is today I'm going to read you a poem from your English book. Okay, it's called My English Folder. Okay, Unit 4, The Paint Box. Right? Every one of us actually love painting, love drawing at a certain point of time. But those who make it a hobby take it far long away with them. They make it into their professions. They become artists, they become architects. The people who love drawing, they draw buildings. You know, architects who draw buildings and all. So that's a part of it. So this is about a little child, and the poem is written by Tali Shurek. Tali Shurek was 11 years old when he wrote this poem. He lived in Beer Sheva, a city in Israel. Israel had faced war and still having war. Israel is always having war. Palestinian Israel is always fighting each other. And struggle since decades, from a long time it's going on. This poem shares the dream of many Israelis of peace and prosperity. Children want peace. Who's going to bomb? You are sitting in the house, you don't know when there's a bomb going to fall and you die. Your parents die in front of you, in front of parents, children are dying. So that's very bad. You know, war is not good. War is loss. Walls on both the sides break. So we have favorite colors in our life, right? We have our we don't like some colors also. At certain points of time we don't want to use it. Like our colors, we use it on our clothes. We try to wear the colors which we like. Like I like black. You can see me mostly wearing black and white. White is my favorite and black is my all-time favorite. I love black. So there is a saying, good guys wear black. I don't know if I'm good or bad, but it says that good guys wear black. It's an American saying. So we have our favorite colors. Everybody has their favorite colors, you know. You must be also having your favorite color. And we use the colors which we don't like the least. Least means the less. We don't want to involve anything into it. You can make a list, you know, by thinking what are your favorite colors and what do you use it for. Like we use yellow for the sun sometimes, we use orange and yellow for the sunset also, we use green sometimes for water, blue for water, green for trees and hills, and blue, brown, black mountains. Red is for, we show it for concern, affection, love. Yellow generally some people like, some people don't like. Blue is good for girls, like pink generally, and blue is always for jeans, you know, this blue color water jeans. The blue water color, people prefer buying those pair of jeans. Then you have this banana leaf green, you know, which is that just the fresh banana leaf which it comes out, that green, that is also very good. Dark green is very good. We have so many types of shades in color, isn't it? So color gives us a lot of information about what that person is trying to say, or what that person is thinking, or what that person is wearing. Also, what type of color that person is wearing, is that a loud color or a soft color? Like loud color means it's very bright and it's not right at that moment of time. You know, sometimes we wear something bright and a dog starts barking, you know. So at that point of time, that color is not used. So color matters a lot. Color plays a very important role in everybody's life. Color matters. So like if I wear something hallucinating and coming to school like a joker, yellow pants and red shirt and, you know, those dark green, dark glasses, and then my hair blue, red, yellow. What is this person is mad? So color defines, you know, if you see me in that thing, you will say, what is this person wearing? Don't we say? Isn't it? But sometimes, yes, if the dress code is okay, that means you are okay. But if your dress code is wrong, we try to judge people with their color also, right? So this was happening a long time ago also, as people did judge each other with colors. This black and white thing was also there. People hate black people. We still, our mother says, "Oh, my, you are fair. That other girl is not fair, or that boy is not fair. You are very good looking." This thing, that color thing is there always. So color plays a very, it's a very, it plays a huge impact on our daily life. So I had a paint box, each color glowing with delight. Each and every color has its glow, right? Even black has that shine in it. A black car, you know, a black solid car, solid color is called a black color. Red solid color is there also. There are called metallics. There are metallic colors also. You have seen, you know, the other cars with shine, lot of shine is there. But black cars have their own shine. A white car is also a solid color. It's not a metallic. White does not come in metallic. A cream color comes in. Off mauve comes in. Off white comes in a metallic color. So a black car, a black Scorpio, when it goes through, you look at it, isn't it? It's so good. That black is also good. Black also has a glow in it. So I had a paint box, each color glowing. Each color has its own glow, its own power, with delight, with happiness. Color means happiness. I had a paint box with colors warm and cool and bright. Dark colors are warm, cool colors are, you know, those bit of those not very bright, not very low also, not very dark. Those are called cool colors, like mint green, peach colors, light blue, sky blues, banana leaf green, the fresh green leaf. Those are called cool colors. Cool, you know, it doesn't, you see that and you feel cool inside. You know, if I wear this or if I use this, it's going to look very cool. And bright colors also. Brights are, you know, these dark reds and dark yellows and those bright, you know, you have these purple colors in bright, and you have these, what not colors are there. But this child, but the poet, Tali Shurek, did not have. Actually, he was painting about the war. He's trying to show, he's wanting peace. So how is he going to show his peace? Through his drawing and through his colors. So I had no red for wounds and blood. Generally, for blood we show red. When we get cut, we show a wound. You know, there's a plaster, even one red dot is there also in the movies. You'll see there while they make up, if they're hurt, one bandage and one red dot. That means that person is hurt, to show that he's got a wound or blood is coming out. I had no black for orphan child. Orphan child means whose parents have died in the bombing, in the war, or a soldier was a soldier fighting for the Israelis in the war, they died. When your parents die, a child becomes an orphan. A child who doesn't have parents is called an orphan. After they are born, the mother, father dies by for any reason, or he's left. So many children are left in India, you know, they are born and they're left. That's something different. That's very sad also. But here, this is also sad. So much of bombing. What are the children? What have the children done? What have we all done? The children of the world. What have they done? It's not their fault of the war. They don't know anything about war. So why this war? So he's trying to predict in his colors that no black. Black is worn when you are sad. When you're mourning, shok. You know that shok word which you use in Hindi, shok manana, that is called mourning. So mourning when you wear black. But again, black is a very positive color. For me, it's very huge confidence. Okay. I had no white for faces of the dead. He did not color the faces of the dead also white. No black. That means no white. White is also for peace generally, but white is, you know, when happens when someone dies, you, if the body is left for some time, you know, that pale color comes, that whitish pale, you know, that blood stops moving, so that glow in that body goes away, that becomes whitish. Not like your wall whites, but it becomes normal, from a normal color it fades off. So he did not paint it for white as color to show that someone is dead. No yellow for burning sands. He didn't put yellow into the sands to show that it's burning, bombing, everything is happening. I had orange for joy and life. He used orange mostly everywhere for joy and life. He wanted that. I had green for buds and blooms. Green is something new coming up, you know, when buds have buds are green on a flower, you'll be seeing a flower, how it blooms. So he had green for buds and blooms. Buds is just before the flower and blooms is just when they have opened into a flower. I had blue for clear, bright skies. Total blue. Beautiful when you see the sky in the morning and so lovely. I had pink for dreams and rest. I sat down and painted peace. I'll come back in the next video and explain this to you.